In terms of the president and his tax cuts, it's actually looking good at this moment. You just never know. But if the President Trump does not get the tax cuts done, does that make his first year in office an epic failure, in your opinion?
Not getting tax reform, King, is without question a huge setback for the president. I don't know if I'd go to epic failure. Not sure about that, but it's a big, big problem for him. And the reason for that is, politics aside, the president's economic policies are basically they're based upon being able to get tax reform. In other words, getting tax cuts to stimulate the economy. If he's not going to be able to get those, again, politics aside, the plan and what he's trying to achieve is not going to work. Now, the president has talked a lot about how well the stock market has done, and we've increased in value $5 trillion since he's been elected. And that's great, and that's being driven by the stock market. If we don't get tax reform, if we don't get some substantial tax cuts specifically related to corporate taxes, how do we know how the stock market is going to react to that? If the stock market starts to adjust itself, because eventually it will, you know, you could really have a bad situation. The other question is, how do we stimulate the economy unless we're going to do something with the tax system? So I think with the budget passing this week, that tax reform is going to happen. I really feel strongly about that. However, I think there's going to be a lot of tweaking and a lot of compromising in the end to get it passed. So it may not exactly be what the president wants, but there's going to be something that I do believe he's going to get. I don't think there's any doubt that everybody recognizes we need tax reform. It's just a matter of what shape and form it's going to take. But I think he gets it, and it probably I'll say it'll save his economic plans. I don't want to say it'll save his presidency.